Over 300 years ago, a catastrophic earthquake shook the northwest coast of America, causing widespread fires and triggering a massive tsunami that claimed the lives of thousands and sent hundreds of settlements underwater. This disaster was the result of Cascadia, a subduction zone where two tectonic plates converge. Every 250 years, there is a shift in Cascadia that results in an earthquake with a magnitude greater than 8. And now, it's happening again. Unlike other earthquakes that are often preceded by inexplicable light flashes in the sky or small tremors in the volcano's vicinity, Cascadia does not give any warning signs. In fact, until the end of the last century, geologists were unaware of the danger posed by this zone. Join us as we dive deeper into this ominous warning given by scientists. Scientists from Oregon State University discovered that the Juan de Fuca plate, which was supposed to descend beneath the North American plate and slide smoothly, got stuck. The pressure between the two plates is increasing, and it's only a matter of time before all that stored energy is released. The probability of an earthquake over the next 50 years is 1 in 3, but there's also a possibility that it could happen in the next couple of years. The disaster will affect the entire Pacific Northwest, including the states of Oregon, Washington, Wyoming, Idaho, Montana, and Northern California. While no one can predict exactly when this will happen, residents are advised to always be prepared and alert. This is because a few minutes of extra caution could potentially save lives. Right before an earthquake, animals such as dogs and mice exhibit strange behavior, like howling and running away, respectively. This is because they have the ability to perceive vibrations that humans can't. Their reactions indicate that the first seismic wave has passed and an earthquake is imminent, with residents of Montana and Wyoming, the more distant states from Cascadia, having about 6 minutes to evacuate to the east. Moving in the opposite direction, towards the edge of the tectonic plate, could result in the creation of a 960-kilometer-long tsunami that could travel at a speed of 19 kilometers per hour. In 1700, a similar tectonic event occurred, causing a massive tsunami that traveled 10,000 kilometers and slammed into the coast of Japan. The water flooded rice fields and caused fires that destroyed buildings. The tsunami was called the Orphan Tsunami because its cause was not understood. This time around, there won't be any time for romantic images, as the earthquake will cause the destruction of thousands of homes, severe fires, landslides, and dam failures. To prepare for such an event, authorities encourage residents to follow the 2 weeks ready plan. This involves every family having a set of essential items, such as food, clothing, and medicine, to survive in extreme conditions for 2 weeks and wait for necessary assistance or evacuation. To use this survival kit, one must first survive the shaking of the earthquake in their own home. To do this, heavy and large items should be moved to the floor or low shelves, and all items that could potentially fall should be removed. Escape routes and doorways should be kept clear of any obstructions, such as furniture, and safety latches should be installed on kitchen cabinets. It's crucial to be prepared, as the devastating earthquake in Northridge, California in 1994 resulted in thousands of injuries and several deaths, with over 50% of the injuries caused by falling furniture or objects. Only 1% of the injuries were caused by building damage. If you live in Oregon, the epicenter of the event, it's even more important to take the necessary precautions. If you're in the epicenter of an earthquake, it's important to know what to do. The first step is to drop, cover, and hold. This means that you should get down on your hands and knees, cover your head and neck, and crawl under a table if possible, or hold on to something sturdy. When the shaking stops, you should leave the building. What you see outside can be devastating. Thousands of buildings will be either demolished or consumed by flames. In Oregon, there are large stockpiles of fuel, not only for the state, but also for Southwest Washington. Fuel tanks will deform and leak, and any spark will be enough to start a fire. The number of tsunami victims can reach over 70,000 people in winter and over 150,000 in summer. Everyone who doesn't have time to escape, leave, or go to higher ground will die, and over 160,000 square kilometers will be flooded. If you think that nothing worse could happen, think again. What if the Cascadia fault is not the end? The disaster in Cascadia could start a chain reaction. You may have heard of the San Andreas fault. It's a continental transform fault between the Pacific plate and the North American plate, extending roughly 1,200 kilometers. It runs along the coast of California, mostly over land. The San Andreas has caused many earthquakes that reached a magnitude of over 9, the most famous being the San Francisco earthquake of 1906. As a result of the earthquake and subsequent fires, up to 3,000 people died, and about 300,000 people were left homeless. 80% of the buildings were destroyed. The earthquake was accompanied by surface fault rupture along the San Andreas Fault, with strike slip displacements measured up to 8.5 meters. The most important thing to note is that the San Andreas Fault merges with the plate boundary of the Cascadia subduction zone north of Cape Mendocino. Researchers recently decided to test whether they affect one another, and it turned out that over the last 3,000 years, a massive earthquake in Cascadia led to the rupture of the San Andreas Fault from 9 to 11 times. This means that when Cascadia gets hit by an earthquake, the San Andreas will follow. Earthquakes will follow one after another, triggering a tsunami, and this time the devastation will spread over an extensive territory from Canada to Mexico. You may think that the catastrophe will only affect the northwest coast of America, but take a good look at the map. Cascadia lies within the so-called Ring of Fire, a string of volcanoes, some of which are best not woken up, like Yellowstone. Its super eruption would equal the force of 1,000 Hiroshima atomic bombs exploding every second. But what are your thoughts about this? If you love our story, don't forget to subscribe to be part of our community. As always, until the next one.